Coming up in this jam video, 3 quick tips to speed up your design workflow. Jam. Hey everybody, welcome back to a new Jam video. Very happy to have you here with me. I'm Rupen from Jammed, and in this video I'll be sharing 3 workflow tips I wish I had known earlier when I started learning about graphic design that would have saved me a shit ton of time. If it's your first time on the channel, here I do design content dedicated for designers like yourself, covering multiple different topics in a short amount of time with the aim to be both informative and entertaining. I would highly appreciate it if you check out this video till the end, and if you liked it, please check out Jam for more cool stuff. Without any more of the intro, let's dive into today's topic, and for the first tip I have for you is utilize bookmarks for easy access to design resources. Personally, I haven't really used bookmarks at all, and only very recently I started to realize how much time they really save. Having everything at the top of your browser for easy access really cuts down a lot of idle time and helps you maximize time spent designing. And you might ask, are these 5 seconds of typing really that big of a deal? No, they're not, you cheeky smart feller, but it's the repetition of the same 5 seconds every day for at least 50 times over the course of 3, 4, or even 10 years. Why not save yourself some time and have a simpler life? Go ahead and try it for yourself, and save the websites you visit regularly, and you will have saved yourself a lot of unnecessary time browsing and more time actually designing. Coming up in number 2, and this is something that you'll hear quite often, set up a custom workspace that suits your design needs. This one is also another great tip that will really optimize your designing experience. How can you know what do you specifically need for your workspace? Ask yourself, what do you regularly design on that software? And track the tools that you use regularly. Make your own personalized workspace, people. Everyone has a different unique working style, and having a personal workspace that is suited for the type of work that you do really cuts down a lot of the bullshit time spent in the app just searching for tools. It is just like building your muscle memory, memorizing where certain tools are so you can eventually reach them without even thinking twice. Just like driving a new car for the first time. At first, it might feel unnatural with the brakes and the gas and how things are placed in the car, but the more you drive that same exact car, the more you become a part of the car. Sort of like, quote unquote, owning it. And you start driving without even thinking about any of that. It becomes automated. You can very easily replicate that same effect by making your own workspace. Simply dock the tabs that you use together, and when you have everything that you use regularly open and organized, you can go ahead and click on Window, Workspace, New Workspace, and then you save it so that when you mess up your workspace a little, you can reset back to where you started. Lastly, get your folder structure right. This has been a really annoying struggle for me during the most of my design career. Learning to have structure for your files is extremely important for designers because having structure simply saves you a ton of time that you're gonna spend later searching for a bunch of files and a lot of unnecessary bullshit that you don't wanna waste time on. A very simple way to start is to set a template folder that you always use for new projects, in which you have everything you need in a specific order. I have my YouTube video template folder set up so that I have assets, the narration, the Premiere files that I use to edit on, the render, and the thumbnail. Because usually I go through all of these steps on each YouTube video. To determine what folder you need, it comes through trial and error. Track what your workflow is like and set up a folder that suits your work. And trust me when I say this. The time you see unnecessary now doing all of these minor optimizations will really save you time in the future. And I believe that time is extremely valuable, especially for cool designers like yourself. That's it for this topic, hope you learned something new. If you enjoyed this video or found it useful, please make sure to jam that like button and share this video with other cool designers, and please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to not miss future jammed content, and let me know down in the comments, have you been using these tips before and were they beneficial for you? Let's have a little chat down there. Also, let me know what other videos you'd like to see next on Jammed. Anyway, I'll see you in the next video and make sure to have a nice one. See you later.